Hello, Penn. Welcome back. I'm your anchor, Ethan Derby.
And I'm Lance Schultz. It is October 21st. Now let's get into this week's news.
On the 14th and 15th last week, the Penn Theater debuted their student-directed one-act plays, 10 Ways to Survive the Zombie Apocalypse, Dinner with the MacGuffins, and The Sussification of a Midsummer Night's Dream. The plays received very positive responses from the audience. Congratulations to the directors and the performers.
Last week, the Penn Marching Band competed in the Indiana State Music Association, or ISSMA, regional competitions. Here's Mahima with an announcement on how they did.
Last Saturday, on October 16th, the Penn Marching Kingsmen competed in the ISMA Regionals at Lafayette Jefferson High School in Lafayette, Indiana. They were joined by many marching bands from around the state, including the Carmel Marching Greyhounds, the Goshen Crimson Band, and the Jimtown Marching Jimmies. The Marching Kingsmen presented their show from a blank canvas at ISMA and received a gold prize for their performance. The band will compete next in the preliminaries for Band of America's Indianapolis Super Regionals at the Lucas Oil Stadium on October 3rd. Good luck to our Marching Kingsmen for Indy and the rest of the season. I'm Mahima Vinay, reporting for Penn. Now back to the desk.
Thank you, Mahima, and good luck to our Marching Kingsmen.
Student fees are now uploading in Skyward. You will need to log into your account to see them. Penn won't be mailing your fee statement home. To see your fees, click on Fees in Skyward Family Access. They must be paid on November 1st, 2021. Any other questions, please go to Kingsman Nation.
Seniors, want to avoid that anxiety after submitting a college application? Well, IUSB is coming to Penn virtually and offering on the spot admission decision next Thursday, October 28th. To sign up for the Zoom meeting, email Mrs. Jensen at jjensen@phm.k12.in.us.
Penn Community. Penn Mart is now open. The Penn Mart has a variety of things such as dog treats at $3, as well as cat treats at $4, sun catchers at $2, also all natural scented candles.
There are clothes left over from last year in the scene shop. Items will be on the shop bench to pick up. If you think something belongs to you or would like to check, you can visit Nora in the CPA office or email nnoble@phm.k12.in.us. Items that have not been collected by the 26th will be tossed.
Now to Jaden with the social calendar and Avery with sports.
I'm Patrick Anderson, and I'll be bringing your social calendar for the week. The Science Academic Super Bowl will be holding meetings every Thursday after school from 3:30 to 4:15 in room 266. Before you can join, you need to do three things. Email Ms. Taboo at ataboo@phm.k12.in.us to join the email list. Pay your transportation fees at the bookstore. They are $10. Last but not least, go to www.registermyathlete.com, select Academic Super Bowl. The Dream Commission Society met on Tuesday, but don't fear, the email to join is here. Here are the emails right here. Looking for a fun way to get involved with the community? Join the DCS, Dream Commission Society. Republican Club is meeting on October 26th in room 173 at 7:40 before school. Have any questions? Email Mr. Schetzel at dschetzel@phm.k12.in.us. Economics and Investment Club met on Tuesday, October 19th, but you can still join by emailing Mr. Reardon, p.reardon@phm.k12.in.us. A friend of mine owned a balloon company, but he had to close it. Couldn't keep up with the cost of inflation. There's a little economic joke for you there. Now back to the desk. Oh wait, back to sports.
Hi, I'm Avery Irving. Let's get into this week's edition of sports. The girls' cross-country team dominated the South Bend sectional at Erskine Golf Course on Saturday, October 9th. They placed five runners in the top 10, including the first three spots, and finished with 25 points. Julie Smith led the charge with a sectional championship run. Julia Ekonomu placed second, followed by Ellie Stabnik in third. Nicole Jerzak placed ninth, and Aubrey Morgan placed 10th to beat the second place team by more than 20 points. In the boys' race, Mariano Retzloff led Penn placing 8th, Carter Kaser followed placing 12th place, and Jason Jarez came in 15th. Both the Penn girls and boys teams qualified for semi-state, slated for 10:30 a.m. on Saturday, October 23rd at Huntington University. Girls volleyball has been back on the come up since their tough loss to Munster, knocking out their last three games 3-0 in each one. Next up, they are going to state against the LaPorte Slicers, with Penn being 34-1 and LaPorte 22-12. We're hoping the girls will have this in the bag. The game will take place Saturday, the 23rd at 10 a.m. And oh, did I mention they're 12-1 in league? Despite that tough loss to Munster, we're hoping the girls can still bring home the state title this weekend. Soccer last week, the girls' soccer team fell short to St. Joe, losing 4-0. The girls had a great season, but unfortunately it came to an end. Congratulations, girls, you fought hard.
Thanks, guys. That looks like all we have for you this week. Hey, Lance, why did the Scarecrow win an award?
I don't know. Why?
Because he was outstanding in his field.
Don't forget to turn in next week for more Halloween jokes on a Halloween show.